Hello everyone, this is Alejandro. I'm just going to go over four different ways to cash out a water simulation for you guys. So in order to do that, we need a water simulation. I am just going to create something here that is really simple. Particle fluids, and I am just going to tell it to flip fluid from object. There we go. And then I am going to create a ground plane. So when we look at it now, it animates and it's working with physics and everything. And right now, this is actually relatively fast. Although, let's trim the area down to 48 frames so that way we can kind of see. So, right now, as it plays, let's go real time. So it plays our 2 seconds. When it cached, it was a bit slower. This is not such a big issue now because you can cache the whole thing. But if we were to go in and make the particle separation much smaller, you'll see that it takes quite a bit more time to cache it. And depending on how much memory you have, you may or may not have the space for it in your memory to be able to load it all the way through. So that's why you might want to be able to cache out a simulation. So looking at this looks really nice. But it is obviously taking quite a bit for 2 seconds. So the first place where we would want to look at to cache out a simulation is here in the AutoDOT network. Okay, cool. So I paused it. And there we go. Okay, so if we looked at the output node here, we have a option here to save to this. So this is actually going to save the cache out into a file. And it's going to be a .sim file. It's saving out dollar SF. SF is for simulated frame. So we're saving in the HIP program or whatever. I'm going to actually change this to my desktop. So that we can have that there really quick. Except I'll just call this test. Okay. I don't want that. I want. Let me copy the name here. Oh, it actually did switch it. Let's make sure. Desktop Sims, and I'll paste that name there so that way it's using the same naming convention. You can see it's the same thing. Okay, so I'm going to pause the video really quick and I'll save to disk. Because this might take a little bit. Okay, so the caching is done now. And it took about 20 minutes for these 2 seconds. And if we go back and play, we can see that even though we saved out the frames, it is still going really slow and it's actually going to slow down. It's not really reading the files completely, so like you will see that once the interaction starts, it's going to get really, really slow here. And the further along, it'll get slower. So what we can do is create a file node in here. And we'll turn the visibility on that. And we are going to go into the sim folder. And I'm going to do a sequence, select the sequence, and click accept. Right now it's set to no operation, so we don't see anything. What I want to do is read files. And this should be a little bit better, because we're looking at the cached out sequence rather than the actual simulation itself. We can see that it does still fill up my memory. I have, I think, 16 gigabytes on this computer of memory. So even with the cached out, it's slowed down because it's a lot of particles and a lot of interaction. But it's a lot better than it was a moment ago, and way better than it was initially for the playback speed. We could do a flipbook and things like that so that we can see it real time, but at least this is more interactive. We could actually scrub back and forth where we wouldn't have been able to do that before. So that's the first way to, or the first area where we might want to cache out animation or the simulation for our water. Now, we also have this sphere object fluid here. In here, we can see that we have two cached areas here. So this first one is going to cache and preview the do the preview geometry. So we can actually go in here and save. So if I, and we can actually click here and kind of see what that geometry is and go to the preview and see it's kind of combination of particles and that preview geometry, the boxes here. So if we go back, we could view that as well. But and actually, if we go back to the AutoDOT network, right now it's reading that out. So let's go here, and this should kind of be a little bit faster now in here. I mean, it's not going to be super fast, but it's better. So basically, we're using the cache directly in the chain now. So, I mean, it's not calculating any of this, but right here it's going to be reading the file and then sending that to the output. So looking at the sphere object here, so we can cache this out. So same kind of thing where we want to make sure that we are saving this where we want it. And I'm just going to steal this, and instead of hip name, I'm just going to get it a name, preview sim set, and then we can save to disk. And when we do that, it should bring up this window, and we can see it going through all the frames and calculating out what the geometry is going to be looking like for this preview geometry. This is going to happen much faster because we have the simulation calculated. Now it is just going through and figuring out how to export this. I mean, how to mesh it. Sorry. So we can see that it's going much, much quicker than 20 minutes like we had for the previous one, or over 20 minutes. This is going to be about a minute, give or take. Let me pause this, and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm right here at the end. So as we got towards the end of the simulation, it did start slowing down, so we can see that we're almost at 3 minutes now. But the last few frames, I mean, with the amount of interaction and the water spreading and things like that, ended up taking quite a bit longer. So we can see, again, kind of the benefit of using these types of cache, because then we don't have to go through this process every time. We can just look at that particular instant. So we're at the last frame now, and when that goes through, we'll look at the animation and how to use this cache file. Should be a few more seconds. Looks like it's going to be pushing 4 minutes. There we go. So if I were to take this, it's still calculating something. There we go. Let's go back to frame one. So it's still trying to calculate all this stuff again, because we're not using the cache even though we saved it out. So it's going through and trying to cook it right now and create the mesh and geometry. So what we can do is here, instead of adding a file node in this case, we have the ability to tell it to load from disk. And it is going to load this simulation. And it's taking it from that same place that we were looking at it before. So now we should see it play much smoother, the animation. Again, because we're meshing it rather than looking at the particles, it's going to be a little bit slower than the previous one where we only had the particles. Then let's look at the next section. So that was the third type. The second type of caching, which is the cache for the preview geometry. If we go over here, we can see that it is going to try to mesh it all the way down to create a smooth version of the water. So this is the final version that's actually rendered. And if we play this, it should be quite a bit slower. I'm going to go here and play. And we can see that even in the first few frames, it is taking quite a bit of time. So in this one, with the fluid simulation here that we're going to create that we want to cache out, it's pretty much the same as with the preview geometry. It's just with the higher res information. So I am going to copy this part of the name and saved it in the wrong spot last time. But I want to put it here in Sims. And this is going to be our render geo. And then I'll click accept. So that saved out the location. Now I'm going to tell it that to save to disk. And it will go through the process of caching out all of the simulation, or the meshing for the simulation of the water. We can see that here at the beginning, the frames are going to go quite fast, but as we get towards the end, it is going to start slowing down quite a bit. I will pause this and we'll take a look at it when the cache finishes. Okay, so the cache finished out for the surface cache, and I can tell it to load from disk now. And if we play this, you can see that it loads up the high poly geometry. It still runs a little slow, but I mean, it's a full geometry. It's not just the particle data that we're playing through right now. So if I stop that and we can go back to the DOP import, and that should play a little bit faster because it's just particle information as we're going through. I mean, it's still kind of slow too, but it gives you a good idea of the cache that we are using. This time the cache took about 30 minutes, a little bit over 30 minutes to do for the high poly geometry that we were working with. But yeah, that's kind of the export time. And that was the third type of caching. The last one that I want to go over for this lesson is the ROP Alembic export, and they have FBX and other types of exports, but I just want to look at the Alembic cache, basically. We're going to export this, and typically you'll use this type of export if we are trying to import into another software an Alembic file. So I'll call this testsim, and it's a .abc file. And I can render to disk, or I can just push this button there, basically turning on the ROP export. And we can do the range. Right now it's doing, I'm just going to use the default range that it's already set up to. Resolution, natural resolution, that's fine. Quality, that's fine. I'm basically going to leave everything at the defaults, and I just click render. And it will go through and create that Alembic file for us. And let's check to see if that was saved. So I have a sim folder on my desktop, but it's on the other window. Here. And test sim, here's the file that is created. And once that's finished caching out, the cache file here, you can use it in whatever software you want, like Maya, or if you wanted to bring it into a game engine like Unreal or anything like that. That's how you would do it. You would want some sort of Alembic file, or you could do the ROP FBX or whatever. You just change the settings for each one of those for what you need to import it. But in this case, I chose an Alembic. It's going to export geometry and then animation, and it'd be all good. So I hope you found this helpful. Please like, share, and subscribe if you did, and we'll see you guys in the next lesson. Bye.